Right there, YouTubers, welcome to Dan Spencer's Bushcraft here. I'm out on a lovely walk, enjoying the summer weather while it lasts. And as I'm very thirsty, I thought what I'd do is test out water purification tablets, as I've never actually tasted how foul apparently they taste. And so before I do that, let's just discuss a little bit about actually purifying water. In the UK, it's certainly no longer really safe to trust any sort of flowing water that you find. You always want to err on the side of caution, either by boiling or adding purification tabs or something like that to it as well, like iodine, etc. So what I'd recommend really in terms of boiling is, they say that once your water is boiled, you can actually drink it if you're in a hurry, as soon as it's come to the boil. I wouldn't really trust that. It all depends on elevation, altitude, all that kind of thing. So leave it to boil between 5 and 10 minutes, depending on how much fuel you've actually got to spare. In terms of water purification, they should always come with instructions, like mine do here, on how to actually use them. If you don't have instructions, make sure you've written them down somewhere so you won't forget. You don't want to get it wrong and end up ill as a result of it. In terms of getting ill from drinking water, it can be parasites, bacteria, anything that's come into contact with the water from upstream, any sort of thing like that can make you ill, either between 6 hours after you drink it, a couple of hours after you drink it. You might be fine for another week or two before you actually get ill. Certain things like giardia, which are on the increase in the UK, can make you very ill indeed. So it is important to err on the side of caution. I have heard as well, if you do have something like a clear plastic bottle, as long as it's nice and sunny, you can leave it strapped to the outside of your rucksack and yet let the UV radiation do the work for you. But as I say, I'd err on the side of caution. So I'm going to try these purification tabs out. Now the stream that I've selected here, you can see it's quite a flat, fast flowing stream. It's all clear water. It's pretty much heading up from the top of the hill, so there's not too much ahead of this. Certainly there's no farmland. You can't use clear water as an indicator of good water quality either, nor can you tell by the smell of it. You want to always, as I say, err on the side of caution, because if you don't, you're going to get very, very sick. You have to also bear in mind that rain can affect toxicity, I suppose you could call it that, of the water. For instance, if you are taking water from a stream in farmland and you have runoff coming from the field where all the cows have shat and sheep have shat and what have you, then that's going to obviously get into the water system which you're going to be taking your water from. It has also been dry recently, so that could mean that the water is not going to be as bad as it could be. But as I say, err on the side of caution. So let's get cracking. Right, so what I'm going to do actually, just before I fill it up, is I am going to filter out any tiny little bits of particulate matter that could get into my water and it could affect how it gets purified. This is also going to come in really handy if your water is really silty. Any silt that gets into your water just by itself could upset your stomach, make you sick, and then you're going to be more dehydrated than when you started. So do excuse me for stripping, but I'm going to use my t-shirt for this. So t-shirt comes off, fold it over a couple of times, and then what I'm going to do, it's a nice hot day at least anyway, so it's not going to be too bad. So let's just see how long this takes. Fortunately I'm not alone in the fact that I'm getting my, my clothes wet for science. My cameraman here in a minute is going to do a test for us, just on how quickly Craig Hopper's shirt actually dries, so see how that goes. I've got one of those myself, you've seen me wear it a few times. So yeah, hopefully it's just going to filter out any little bits of particulate, plant life, anything like that, out of it. Again, you just don't want to expose yourself to anything you don't really need to. So I'll put that filling up. Not very quickly at all. That's going to come on something a little bit quicker flowing. So something like that. Maybe I've been a little bit too keen on my filtration in my shirt. Maybe just a single layer will do. There we are. Let's get it. It's all wet anyway. Doesn't matter. Well, we're slowly filling up, so I'll pop back to you once I've got it full. See you in a couple of minutes. Right, so I've just collected my water. It took a bit of time actually filtering it through my t-shirt, so I actually went down to just a single layer of fabric, and then what I actually found worked best is I created like a little channel just to lay my bottle in by there. Got the pressure of the water flowing down onto the top, which is covered in the fabric, and then just sort of poking the bottle, which releases a bit of air, creates a bit of suction and helps to pull the water in, and that now has left that water really clear. So I did notice there's a few little bits bits and pieces really just floating around in that water, but I can see now that there's definitely none in the bottle itself, so let's get these pieces out of the way. Next stage is Fury tab goes in, so yeah, on this one, sodium dichloro-isocyanurate, 70 milligrams, one tablet purified, 1 litre water, leave for 10 minutes before use. So let's drop that open. Okay, and it's just important to note as well, when you're doing this, just make sure that your purity tabs are always kept dry. So this is from a survival tin. There we are, that's gone in there. This is from a survival tin, so I know they're kept dry. If they do get wet, then they start to react inside the packet, so it's not going to be very effective when you actually come to use it if you really need it. So they're going to go straight back in the survival tin just now. Pop those out there, ready to go in. So the last thing is, once you've got your water filtered and clean, is you just want to filter anywhere that's been in contact with the bottle. So for instance, I'm loosening the cap there, and I'm also going to loosen this lid and just give it a little bit of a shake. So you're going to let the water come through, so I'm going to do that just now. And that just means that you're cleaning a little bit of the top of the bottle there as well. The purity tab still sat at the bottom there, and so I'll do that again maybe about 5 or 6 minutes in, just to make sure that it's getting a pretty decent clean, and then we're good to go. The last thing to probably note about using purity tabs or anything that's reacting with the water is that the colder the water is, the longer it's going to take. So that says 10 minutes. This water's pretty chilly, to be honest, so I'm going to leave it for 15 minutes. So once we finish 15 minutes time, then we'll do the all important taste test. So I'll see you in about 15 minutes. Right, well it's been, well do you know what, it's probably been about 20 minutes now. I give it a little extra 5 minutes once I'd rinsed the top. Do bear with me, I think I'm getting munched alive by flies by here, but the all important taste test. So here goes, let's see if it tastes like arse or not. Do you know what? It's not nearly as bad as people make out. It's not nearly as bad at all. Actually, I'm quite happy with that. So I suppose the proof will be in the pudding, see if I start chucking my guts up during the week or not. If not, I'll assume that I did everything right and that it was in fact okay. I suppose while I'm talking about the taste, I can talk about what you can do to alleviate that taste. I've heard apparently putting a little bit of charcoal in there helps to detract from the taste of the chemicals. To me, it just tastes faintly like swimming pool water. I drunk plenty of that as a kid, so I'm not too fussed about that. Also, if you are boiling water to purify it, the water can go quite flat. So what you can do to help oxygenate it and give it back some of its sort of watery flavour is give it a damn good stir, or you can pour it back and forth from one container to another, as long as they're both sterile, obviously, and that will help with that. But there you go, cameraman, are you up for a little try of this? There you go, go on. So still waiting for his shirt to dry. What do you reckon? Tell us about it. Give us some words.
Tastes good.
There we are.
Drinkable.
There we are. Man of many words there, Mr. Wilson. Right, well, that's been me purifying water. I hope it's okay. I'll let you know if it's not anyway. It'll be a funny story if nothing else. But other than that, I'm going to get back to my lovely hike now. Take care for now.